What's going on YouTube? It's your favorite Godox hype beast, Robert Hall, and today we're going to talk about a new product that can take two Godox AD200s and merge that power into one beam of awesome. Before we get into this accessory, we're going to do a quick recap on the Godox AD200. If you don't know, this is a lot of people's new favorite pocket flash. It is an OCF only off-camera flash, not on-camera flash. This is an OCF only 200 watt Godox X series compatible flash that does TTL high speed sync and no cores, nothing. It's all one internal battery pack. Fast becoming a lot of people's favorite new light. I know it's now my primary off-camera light. I have two of them and I use them every single day that I am shooting. But there is one little hitch with this, and that is it just doesn't quite have the power to be a very flexible light in bright conditions. In that, yes, if it's right on top of your subject in a soft modifier, yeah, you can beat the sun or balance with bright conditions, but you don't have a lot of flexibility. You can't pull it way back. It's not gonna have the distance that an 8600 will have, and that's pretty much its only shortcoming. But this product right here aims to solve that. There's not even a manual. They just put the manual on the back, although there's not much to it, and we're gonna go over it here. So what does this thing do? It has a few different configurations, but all it is a Bowens S-mount, very similar to the S-mount adapter that Godox offers, except it's filled with some electronics that allow you to put one or two AD200 bulbs. Also, this whole video, I'm going to speak in Godox terms, but this all applies to the Flashpoint eVolv and Streaklight, and that stuff's all the same if you guys haven't figured that out yet. And yes, it works interchangeably. So there's a one and a two on the back, one on the left, two on the right. And the first configuration is just putting a single AD200 and a single AD200 bulb in the one slot. And this just kind of bridges the gap between the Bowens S-mount adapter, because the S-mount adapter doesn't fit unless you rig it, which I've got a video on that if you wanna see. But there is a benefit to using it like this instead of just putting one of these in a rigged Bowens S-mount adapter. And that benefit is it gets a little bit more power because it's a completely closed off unit. And so more of this light actually reflects off of this base and fires out in your modifier instead of slipping out the back of the Bowens S-mount bracket. We'll get into those power details later. The next configuration is adding a second AD200 to the back and adding a second 8200 bare bulb to the front, which means you'll get even greater than a full stop of light out of this than you would a Bowens S-mount adapter. All you have to do is put your two lights in the same group and you'll be able to get all of that power delivered out of the front of this AD-B2. Another feature is that there are two small LED panels and they're actually quite bright. I was really surprised and impressed by this. So you can see we've actually got a significant amount of power coming out of these, far more power than you'll find out of the Fresnel head or the LED attachment that you can get for the AD200. And you also get three levels of brightness out of this. And I think this would serve as a pretty adequate modeling light when used in a softbox. So let's talk power numbers in comparison to the AD360 and the AD200 as a standalone. For clarification, all my numbers were done at 10 feet using the 7-inch reflector attached to the Bowens S-mount bracket, or this. So first up, 8200 with its bare bulb in the 7-inch reflector, that got an f5.6 and 9/10 of a stop, so just under f8. The 8360 version 2 in that Bowens S-mount adapter got an f8 and 6/10 of a stop, so it was 0.7 stops higher than a single 8200, which is really consistent with my last power test, which if you want, you can find that here. Now here's where things get interesting. When I put one 8200 on the AD-B2 with one 8200 bare bulb, we got a metered reading of f8 and 2/10 of a stop, meaning it was a third of a stop more than the 8200 in a Bowens S-mount bracket. And that's what I was talking about before, that because this is closed and has the silver to actually bounce the light off of, you get a little bit more power simply by putting the 8200 on this rather than just sticking it in that S bracket. And finally, I did the two 8200s with two bare bulbs, two 8200 bare bulbs, and that scored the highest at f11.2. Now, there's a reason I bring up those numbers. because as I said at the beginning, the AD200 does struggle a little bit when it's by itself in a big modifier and you're trying to balance with really bright conditions like direct sunlight outside. Yes, it can be done if your flash modifier is directly on top of your subject, but that's not how I always want my light modifier to be. So I decided to take it out for a test today to just experience how well it's going to perform outside in bright conditions. Thankfully, it was super sunny today. We went around 11:30, so shortly before the sun was at its brightest point, and it was hot. It was like 85 degrees outside. So just the type of conditions that I'm looking for to see how this performs in. So with the models back against the subject and this thing with a 24-inch double diffuse softbox on it performed great. I could keep this pretty distant from the subject to easily keep it out of the frame. I didn't have to have it right on top of her. And we're talking high speed sync, 1/4000th of a second. If I wasn't using high speed sync, then it would be no problem. But I don't like jumping up to F11 or F13 for outdoor portraiture, so I use high speed sync in those situations. And it had no problem illuminating the subject to the point where my background was a little bit darker, despite being hit by bright sunlight. In fact, I even turned my subject to face the sunlight. So her face was being hit by the direct sun as well as the entire background. And I was able to stop down the background by about 3 stops so that my model was very dark and the background was very dark. And then I put this at full power, about 1.5-2 feet away, and it illuminated her really well. So not only is this something that can keep up with bright conditions, it's something that can actually overpower direct sunlight hitting a subject at high noon. And from there, I kind of just spread it out, tried to get more distance out of it, and played with the power setting. And most of the time I was between a half power and an eighth power when using it outside in relatively close proximity to the model, but I certainly wasn't keeping it right on top of her like I would if I was only using a single 8200 outdoors. Do want to quickly touch on the format of this. Once you have two 8200s, the AD-B2 and two bulbs, you're right around 5 pounds. So you're flirting with the same size and weight as an 8600. But we're also quite close to the power that you get out of an 8600. But the primary benefit of this is that it's one light when you need the power and two lights when you don't. That's how I plan on using it. This AD-B2 will sit in my car unless I'm outside in bright conditions. Otherwise, I'll use the 8200s as I've been using them, which is on stands as two separate flashes all day as my primary off-camera flash units. There's no way to make an 8600 two lights, but with this you can. And the power difference between these two is quite negligible to the point where I'm gonna be leaving my 8600 at home for weddings now. There's really no other surprises to it. It does have, unfortunately, that same rackety type handle, but I've grown to kind of appreciate it because despite being plastic and lightweight, it does hold up and hold the position of the light really rigidly, which I don't think there's any other way to do with plastic other than this little clanky handle. So overall, I have no complaints about this. I really like it. It's a simple product and it actually comes in quite cheaper than people expected. I myself expected something like this to run $120, $150, but it's only $60 to $70 depending on where you're going to be ordering from. There is a Flashpoint equivalent in the States. I'll keep that link in the description. You can buy direct from Godox. I'd expect all the US distributors as well as UK distributors and Canadian distributors, I expect they're all going to have a version of this because it's something that a lot of people are interested in. So I'll update links where you can buy it in the description. Hope you guys enjoyed this first look slash review on the AD-B2. If you have any questions, you can leave them in the comments, although I'm far more active in my photography gear chat group on Facebook, which in addition to contacting me quicker, you can also get the opinion of thousands of other photographers who have joined the group. So if you're interested in that, the link is in the description. Otherwise, like if this helped you out, share it with somebody who might enjoy it, and subscribe if you want to see more videos from me. And until next time, keep on shooting, YouTube.